This is a Thor News presentation. Thor News presents this chapter of the Astonishers Team Asteroid Division. All began when I said to myself, "Hey, I would like to check around and see if there's any asteroid news." And what do you know? One of Thor News' favorite scientists' last tweet was, "At Nat Geo, hi, we're discovering this asteroid with the NEOWISE mission. It's not named the Beast. It's called 2014 Headquarters 124. I'm like, "What the heck? Why would you call an asteroid a beast? Beasts are alive, man. You know, like, I don't think a rock can be a beast. It can be a mountain 7 steady high thrown into an ocean, but it can't be a beast. Beasts are alive. They have moving parts." Alright, so we are starstruck and exploring the universe. Apparently, Miss Manger was correcting Andrew Phasecast when he said, "Watch as the beast asteroid sails past Earth this week." Can't sail past, man. Doesn't have a sail. Unless you know something we don't. To really sail, you gotta have a sail. That's how it works. Confusing, I know. Maybe you might watch as the beast asteroid sails past Earth this week. SALES. Like you're trying to sail them. You're blog posts? So here comes the asteroid. Oh no. Yeah, it's close. And I, Thor News, have been tracking this asteroid ever since they put it on the JPL Close Approach data thingy. Why? Because A, it used to be a lot bigger. That's what she said. Used to be up to 820 kilometers to like 300, 300 to 800. I don't necessarily know. And earlier today, I was getting all my media ready for the weekend, 'cause I got like 6 videos to make, finish, all that jazz. Of course, a new story pops up. It's not even one of those. So, not getting any sleep tonight again here. And I noticed the story all really began when I noticed checking out Asteroid 2014, Honeyquake 124. At the very bottom, like there was the estimate of how big it might have been. Became a solid number. And right by it was said, "Amy Manger personal communication." I was like, "Ha ha, crap." You know, I look like a fool. Total unrequited internet flirting. And being blocked on Twitter is about as artwork showing an asteroid zipping by the Earth-Moon system. Yeah. astronomy, art's the best, because somehow we can never get good photographs of these things, no matter how big they are. Measuring about 1,067 feet, 325 meters wide, the space intruder nicknamed the Beast. Now, who nicknamed it? More formally known as the name Amy Mainzer referred to, Handsome Quixotic 124. I wonder who she nicknamed that asteroid after. It has an estimated width equal to an aircraft carrier. Earlier estimates have been even larger. Hey, dude, that's what I said earlier. Now you're ripping me off. It will be 3 lunar distances away from Earth. 3.3. Dude, get shit straight. You can be lazy as you make the shit up. Like, really, who nicknamed it that? You? How's it a space intruder? It's in space the whole time. It's in outer space. We're in inner space. It's not coming anywhere close to inner space. Says Miss Mainzer in all professional science. And I'm sure Phil Play will back her up and Tyson DeGrasse too. However, it's a big one. That's what she said. And maybe she really said that. And we didn't notice its approach until April 23rd. Well, it's nothing new. Thanks to the dedicated telescope surveys, to hear about asteroids whizzing past Earth or the Moon is unusual to see such a large one go unnoticed for so long. That has so much innuendo in it. Telling you, astronomy's perverted. But it's natural to be attracted to beautiful, intelligent women. It's called emotional gravity. NASA's Wide Field Infrared Survey Explorer picked up its movements against a fixed backdrop of stars, traveling at approximately 31,000 miles per hour. That doesn't sound very approximate. Do you know the odds of it landing on 000? It's like 1 in 1,000, bro. I think. Maybe myself. Not that good, man. It will be 3 lunar distances away from Earth at its closest approach on Thursday. So thankfully, there's no risk to our planet. Wait, the 8th isn't Thursday. The 8th is Sunday. Weird. Alright. So it's gonna be coming around. So it's coming down to the Phoenix. And it's gonna pass on through the Horologium, and it's gonna lightly brush against the rectum and end up at the Dorado. down two toe and arms. Up at a giant green plant where that red thing doesn't push it towards us. Mess is smart enough to figure out how to solve that problem. Thanks, Mensa. The sun's back and freaky funky. Heck, the whole solar system's back and freaky funky. Yeah! In this whole Jedi fighting program, Amy Manger and I are kind of like Superman and Wonder Woman. Neo, Trinity, 0.7 Sigma, personal communication from Amy Manger, May 30th, 2014. Neo Eyes Thermal Model. I would like personal communication from Amy Manger. Asteroid 2014. Honeyquake 124.